Hey y'all, and welcome back to the garden. I'm Melissa Almond, and a friend of mine called me and said that she has got some Mac Daddy roses that need pruning down. So I drove up here, and as you've seen before, I've got one other video that shows how to prune younger, smaller roses. But if you see these, they are really big. And I'm gonna show you how to go ahead and cut these way back. Now keep in mind, these roses right here are only 3 years old. So they're really big, and right now it's the middle of March, and you can see they've already put on some new growth. And when you go into a rose this big and you cut him down, you might as well know that it's going to take 4 to 6 weeks before that rose is going to bloom again. So you just want to cut him down, fertilize him in early spring, just like right now, and it should come back really nice for you. So I'm going to show you how to do all that. First, we're going to put on a nice jacket. Okay, it's really not that nice, but we have to wear it because roses like to poke you. Okay. Now this rose right here has a really nice form to it. And I do have hand pruners right here, the little snips, and I've got some larger ones right here. And they are adjustable in case you need to reach, and they do lock. So, let's get to pruning. Now, the best way to prune your rose is look how big he is. You can start pruning at the top and prune down on him to a certain height. Now, you can cut these knockout roses back pretty good. You can cut them down to about 2 or 3 feet tall, and once you do, you want to make sure they have a nice skeleton. And once I'm through with this one, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. Look at the thorns on it. That's why you need a nice jacket and nice gloves. See here, when I'm pruning, you can see where each one of these new little buds are coming out. One's there, and you want to snip it right above. You want to leave that bud and snip it right above that bud. That way that bud will still come on out. You can see here now, I've taken him back a pretty good ways, and that's going to help a lot. And once it goes through a big bloom session, you'll probably have to go in there and cut them down again. And as you can tell, I'm cutting this one at least halfway back from where it was. And if you notice, it's got a pretty strong skeleton here. You can see. That way it'll hold up the weight, because this is actually a young rose. It's only 3 years old. And there's some branches inside that you want to cut out if they're growing into the center or they look weak. You can just trim those out. Make it look real good. All right, there you have it. There's one rose. I'm still probably going to take a few things off. Whoops. Much better. See what a nice thick stalk it's got down here? You really don't want to cut into the crown of the rose. You don't want to hurt that part down here. But all this in here, you can take it down pretty much as far as you want to on a heavy rose like this one. And this is your knockout rose. And it is just going to be gorgeous.
See, we're almost
almost done with this one. Trying to cut out anything that's coming over into the center. Because you need air circulation in your roses, or they want to get mildewy. Almost done. Now I hope this has helped you learn how to cut your roses down. Don't be afraid of them, other than their thorns. But you can just prune them on down and have them keep, let them have a nice skeleton. I keep talking about their skeleton, but you do want them to have a pretty nice skeleton. So, sure do appreciate you watching.